Today we are going to see Standard 5th Social from Term 3. The lesson name is Forts and Palaces. In this lesson, let us see the importance of forts and palaces in Tamil Nadu. Come, let us move to the video session.
Unit 1, Forts and Palaces. In this lesson, let us see the history of forts and palaces in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu has been ruled by several empires, that means especially Chera, Chola, Pandya and Pallava rulers. We have already studied in the term 2, that means Chera, Cholas, Pandya. And even the Pallava rulers also empired in a Tamil Nadu. Cholas and Pandyas, along with them, Nayakas are constructed a magnificent forts and palaces in Tamil Nadu. They are the three kings or rulers constructed many forts and palaces. After a long time, the Dutch people, that means the British people, French, everybody enter into our country and they build the forts to protect their territories, because forts means it is very much safe and nobody can enter into the forts because it's fully covered and no the thief or other peoples can enter into the forts. Let us see what is meant by fort. Fort is nothing but architectural monuments are now preserved in the form of palace, forts and other historical sites in Tamil Nadu. That means even today many palaces and forts are in a good condition, which were built in the Pallava rulers, Chera, Chola, Pandyas, and some forts were built by the British ruler. That means the foreign peoples were ruled our country. These are the things which we are using as a historical sites, which is there in Tamil Nadu. Let us see one by one. These are the prime attraction, that means the center of attraction for the tourist who came for Tamil Nadu to visit all the fort. Vellore Fort. Vellore Fort is a 16th century fort situated in Vellore, that means which is there in Tamil Nadu. We will say it is an Vellore, that is called as Vellore. It was built in the year, that means 16th century. It is also called as Kings of Vijayanagara, that means it was the kings ruled, so it is named as Kings of Vijayanagara. Among the forts in Tamil Nadu, Vellore Fort is considered to be one of the most invisible fort, that means we can see everything. It is surrounded by a deep and wide moat. That means the water of this moat was a home to thousands of crocodile, because there will be thousands of crocodile will be present. For what means it was a thing which the other peoples, for example the unwanted peoples enter into the fort, they don't know what is there inside. So they were built the fort like this, where thousands of crocodiles were lived in the fort. Because of that, the enemies will be afraid. The fort is a good example for military architect. That means it is only meant for military architecture. It is start with double fortification, that means for example if you see the double decker bus, it will be both the sides, it will be there both the ways we can go. The same thing we can have a double fortification. In 1799, Tipu Sultan family was detained here by the British. Tipu Sultan family was detained, that means the British people catch the Tipu Sultan family in 1799. The first rebellion against the British broke out at Vellore Fort in 1806. That means the first fort which were be British broke out at Vellore is called, that is a Vellore Fort, in the year 1806. Inside the Vellore Fort, there is a well-known temple called Jalagandeshwara Temple. There is a church, mosque and museum, and even several government offices are there. In Vellore Fort, we have five important mahals. That means Aider Mahal, Tipu Mahal, Beham Mahal, Candy Mahal and Badusha Mahal. That means these are the five great mahals which is there in Vellore Fort. Next is Dindigul Fort. Dindigul Fort was built in the 17th century. Vellore Fort was in 16th century. Dindigul Fort is in a 17th century. That is a hill fort situated in Dindigul in Tamil Nadu. It is also called as Dindigul Malaikottai. That means it is also has a name Dindigul Malaikottai. We all know it was built in the 18th century. The fort was passed on to the Kingdom of Mysore. That means it is the Kingdom of Mysore. Dindigul Fort was built by the Nayakas. That means who are there in the Madurai? They are the Nayakas in order to defend their region from the invading Mysore army. They have to protect the Mysore army. The Nayakas built the Dindigul Fort. Presently, the fort is maintained by the Archaeological Survey of India. We have already studied about archaeological, that means ASI. The fort was cemented with a double walls. There will be a double walls will be there to withstand heavy artillery, because then only it will be very strong. In Tamil Nadu, that means in Chennai, we have a Fort St. George is a first fort built by the British in India. We have, nowadays also we have a Fort St. George. It is located in Chennai, that means state secretariat of, there we are functioning the, inside the fort. It is a secretariat for the Chennai. Fort St. George is a very much famous fort which is there in Chennai. Thirumayam Fort is only famous for artist work and architectural brilliance. It is located in Pudukottai, which is there in Tamil Nadu. That means only it is famous for artist. That means for paintings it is more popular. And it is also most popularly it is famous for large rock inscription. Rock means it is a large stone. For example, if you can see many things in Mahabalipuram, they can make a statue with the help of a stone, everything. The same like you can see in a Thirumayam Fort. It is also known as Umayan Kottai. That means it is a, has a another name, that is Umayan Kottai. The magnificent Sardar Fort was built for the commercial purpose by the Dutch people. Dutch people means who were ruled our country in the early time. It is located in Kanchipuram. You can see the picture. It is a Sardar Fort. It is built by the Dutch people. It is also there in Kanchipuram. Next we are going to see about Jinji Fort. Jinji Fort is the other beautiful fort which is there in Tamil Nadu. It looks so beautiful. It is located in Viluppuram district. Jinji Fort is built across three hills. There will be three hills will be there. Across that they have built a Jinji Fort. The fort walls will be 13 kilometer long and three hills were connected by the walls. One wall is connected by a three hills. It is 13 kilometer long. It has a height of 800 feet. That means it has a height. And it is also protected by a 80 feet wide moat. That means we have seen about the crocodile, the same like it has a wide feet which has a moat. It is a huge fort with many attractions like Kalyan Mahals, temple, pond, granaries and watchtower. Watchtower means the people will be watching from the higher position. That is called as watchtower. Tarangambadi Fort is locally called Danish Fort. It is as a other name, that is Danish Fort. It is located on the shores of Bay of Bengal. That means shore means we will play in the shore, seashore. That is called seashore, which is there in the Bay of Bengal. There they have built a fort, that is Tarangambadi Fort, that is near to the sea. The fort is trapezoidal in space with three rooms in the left wing. That means wings means in the left hand side there will be having a three rooms. The central part of the fort has four domes. For example, in the bike we have a domes. The light is also called as a dome. Like a dome, we have a four domes will be there in the center part of a Tarangambadi fort. The central pillar of the hall holds the entire weight of the domes. The four domes will be held by the center pillar of the Tarangambadi fort. It is the most famous Tarangambadi fort. Tamil Nadu has a great palaces in many places. Let us see one by one. Next we are going to study about palace. First one, Tirumalai Nayakar Palace. It is the majestic Tirumalai Nayakar Palace. It was built in the year 17th century. It is the architecture of Nayakar destiny. That means it is most, that means fully it was built by the Nayakas. It is one of the most popular palace in South India, which is there in Tamil Nadu. Tirumalai Nayakar Palace is located in the city of Madurai. It was situated in the city of Madurai. This is one of the tourist parts of Tamil Nadu. It is a major tourist parts which is there in Tamil Nadu. It is in the city called Madurai. Tirumalai Nayakar Palace is widely known for the gained pillars. That means it will be very very big pillars will be there. You can see in the picture fully tower pillar. It has an archaeological museum. The major attraction of the palace is courtyard and the dancing hall. It looks like a dancing hall. So it is named as a dancing hall. Let us know some important news. Tamukkam Palace was the summer residence of the Queen Rani Mangammal. And it is also a Nayakar destiny. It is also located in Madurai. It is mostly famous for Queen Rani Mangammal, which is there in Madurai. The palace name is Tamukkam Palace. Fen Hills Palace in Ooty served as a summer palace for the King of Mysore. Whoever is living in Mysore, the kings, they were famous for the Ooty Fen Hills Palace. It is a summer palace for the kings who are there in the Mysore. Tanjavur Marada Palace. Tanjavur Marada Palace is popularly called Tanjavur Aranmanai. That means it is popularly called as Aranmanai of Tanjavur. It is originally constructed by the rulers of Tanjavur Nayakar. That means who were lived in Tanjavur, the Nayakars were built the Tanjavur Maratha Palace. After the fall of Tanjavur Nayakar Kingdom, it is served as the official residence for Tanjavur Maratha. After the Nayakars, there were be several people were ruled. So it is officially called as Tanjavur Maratha. Tanjavur complex, that means Tanjavur Palace, has a attraction for the tourist. It has a three separate venues, that means the palace, the art gallery and the manuscript library. They are the three things which we have in the Saraswati Mahal. Manuscript means it is also called as a Saraswati Mahal. Let us see what is meant by Saraswati Mahal. Saraswati Mahal is considered as one of the oldest historical libraries in India because it is one of the most oldest libraries in India. It is a library. You all know library means it has many books. It is also has a museum. The library has more than a million manuscripts in languages like Tamil, Sanskrit, Marathi, Telugu and Manipralavam. That means these are the language which we have the books in the museum. That means in the library. It is the oldest library. Her name is Saraswati Mahal. The library name is Saraswati Mahal. This is one of the oldest library in India. Padmanabhapuram Palace. It is a beautiful historical monument which is situated in Padmanabhapuram. It's there in Kanyakumari district. It is also called as Kalkulam Palace. That means it is a wooden palace which built in Kerala style. It fully made up of wood. It is have a fine example for art and craftsmanship. The Padmanabhapuram Palace is mainly for queens, kings, everyone. The floor will be made up of coconut shell, milk, eggs. These are the things which makes the floor more shining. If you go for Kanyakumari, please visit Padmanabhapuram Palace. It is most historical monuments in Kanyakumari. The Padmanabhapuram Palace was built by the ruler of Taravankur. The palace has various sections like Queen Mother, that means the queen and the mother. Queen of the mother lived. The same like King's Palace is also there. Queen Palace, Council Chamber. There will be many architectural things will be found in Padmanabhapuram Palace. Even Southern Palace. Southern Palace means it is found in South India. So it is called as Southern Palace. We can see many artificial and man-made things in Padmanabhapuram Palace which were used by the kings and queens. I hope you all understood about the lesson forts and palaces. Thank you, students.